As we proceed north on Highway 10, we pass through a flat, sandy area following a route that at an earlier time was used as an oxcart trail. The trail was known as the Woods Trail because, unlike the trail which passed along the Minnesota River Valley, it kept to the Mississippi until it reached the river crossing at Crow Wings, and then cut through the woods toward the Red River Valley. The Woods Trail was the more difficult of the two in many ways, but it offered travelers and merchants a greater likelihood of safe passage than the Prairie Trail, which was more vulnerable to attacks by hostile Dakota bands. The oxcart era hasn't captured the public imagination in quite the same way as the railroads, steamboats, or even the voyagers did, yet it marks a fascinating, albeit brief, chapter in the history of the region. The wooden carts had originally been designed and used locally in the Red River Valley to transport the hides gathered by the French and Indian mixed bloods known as the Métis at their annual buffalo hunts. In the period between the 1840s and the 1860s, the oxcart trails fanned out as a broader network across the prairies to the north and west of the Mississippi. Furs from the forests and plains of the Canadian hinterlands would be collected at Fort Garry and on the shores of Lake Winnipeg in Canada and brought to St. Paul in long caravans, some reaching more than 200 carts in length. Many of the drivers were Métis, French Canadians, or Scots. Having deposited their valuable freight, the carts were reloaded with tobacco, liquor, guns, and other manufactured goods that were hard to come by on the distant outposts to the west. It was a long journey and also a noisy one. The carts were usually made entirely of wood, and as the caravans moved slowly across the prairie, the squeaking of the axles could be heard 5 miles away. All the same, it was a far easier and cheaper way for the inhabitants of the Red River Valley to travel along this route than via a complicated chain of lakes to the Great Lakes, or to proceed north along often treacherous rivers to Hudson's Bay and thence by ship through Arctic waters to the Atlantic. One of the most difficult parts of any oxcart journey were the river crossings, and the Mississippi presented perhaps one of the greatest challenges. Towns frequently sprang up at the fords. One such crossing was at Sauk Rapids, which we'll soon be approaching. A trading post was established here as early as 1805, just below the mouth of the Sauk River. In 1850, steamboats began to ply the waters of the Mississippi between Sauk Rapids and St. Anthony's Falls, and a year later, W.H. Wood built a large mansion in the vicinity and named it Linden Hills. Other settlers arrived, and a store, a hotel, and a jail soon followed. The prominence of the town as a transportation center in Minnesota's early history may be suggested by the fact that its newspaper, the Sauk Rapids Frontiersman, was the state's second newspaper. Sauk Rapids' growth was slowed somewhat when the railroads proceeded westward, out into the prairies. It suffered a major setback when most of the downtown area was wiped out by a tornado in 1886, and St. Cloud eventually overtook it as a regional center.